Antonio, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Will Ross Barkley make his debut against Norwich?
No, because he's not able to play because the transfer was late, no?
Yeah, if he'd signed by midday on that day, he could play, but he signed in the evening, so he's not eligible.
Will he be ready for the weekend game against?
Probably we are preparing a friendly game for him during this week. And then we'll see his physical condition, but... As I said before, and I'm very happy. I'm very happy for his commitment, for his physical condition, and he could be ready. He could be ready for the next game or for the next game.
Have you any fresh injury concerns for the Norwich game?
The Cahill, but his problem is not so serious. A muscular problem, and then also Cesc had a little problem in his hamstring, and he's not available for tomorrow's game.
You've kept three clean sheets in a row, but you haven't scored for three games. Without being disrespectful to Norwich, you play at home against a team from the league below. Is it a good chance to try and find that confidence in the attacking third?
Yeah, I think this game is an important game, and it's a good chance to continue to keep the clean sheet, because it's not easy, and then to try to win the game, to try to score and to win the game, and to go to the next round. Yeah, but as you know very well, this type of game are very difficult, and we have to pay great attention. We have to pay great attention and to try to win the game.
Are you actively trying to sign Alexis Sanchez?
I don't know. I don't think so. I don't know. I don't know, but I don't think so.
Jose Mourinho said recently that when players of his quality become available in January, it's impossible to ignore them. Would you agree with that statement?
No, but about the transfer market, as you know very well, I prefer to talk the club and also to give opinion and also to be I repeat, and I don't want to give my opinion about the transfer market.
Have you told the club that you would like to try and sign Alexis Sanchez?
Well, I think he's already said that he doesn't know anything really about that situation. He doesn't think so. Quickly move on, or we'll move around the room.
Yeah, I don't know if this falls into that category, but Michy Batshuayi, can you confirm that he is close to moving away on loan? Is that close?
Michy Batshuayi is a Chelsea's player, and he's in our squad, and tomorrow he has to play, and then I think this is the truth until now, and he's a Chelsea player, and he's having his possibility to show that he deserves to play for Chelsea. Now this is the reality. This is the truth. And then in the future, and I don't know what happened. Also because the last the final decision is for the club, not for me.
Speak generally about transfers. Are you happy? Are you confident that at this stage you can add to your squad this month?
But, I try to work with my players. I'm very happy to work with my players, and I think that we are working very well. We are working very hard to try to build something important for this club, and this is my first task, and then. If someone asks me my opinion about the situation, if we can improve or not, I can give my opinion. But I repeat, I think that the most important thing for me and for my players to work and to continue to exploit this this squad in the right way, to try to improve every single player, and yeah, and stop.
Question on Eden Hazard. He has, in his last 8 games, he's only played full 90 minutes once. Is that managing his return from that injury he had, or is it a tactical decision?
But we are talking about a player that recently he had a bad injury in his ankle, and he had a surgery. And usually when you have this type of situation, and you must pay great attention, because during the season you can have up and down, also because he missed the pre-season with us. I think that with him we are trying to find the best way, and it's normal that one player can keep always at top of the form, and but like the other, and my task is to try to improve him, to try to put him in the best physical condition, to try to take the best decision for the team during the game, not only for him, but for every single player.
Does he agree with that approach, or does he just want to play every minute of every game?
No, this is not important. I'm the coach. I decide. It's not important if one player is happy or not happy. And only here there is this this habit. And you are very worried for if the player is happy or not happy. Mm-hmm. Only here there is this habit. And this is not important. My task, my first target is to do the best for the player and for the team, not to make every single player happy. Otherwise, and we risk to finish 20 in the table. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Let's move. Sorry, we're going to have to keep moving around the room, Paul, because there's a lot to go through. Someone who is happy to be here is Moose, currently.
Yeah, but every press conference there is always this. But and are you worried to make your player happy? Yeah. No, my worry to win.
Are you worried then about a lack of goals?
But this is a good question also because now this is a real problem for us, and we are not conceding goal, and this is a good news, but the bad news that we are not scoring, and for sure we have to try to improve under this aspect. My players know very well that they can improve. Also because if you compare to past, and every single player scored less than last season. For this reason, we must be worried not if one player is happy or not happy.
In that respect, is it good you're playing at home tomorrow against a lower-ranked team, Norwich, because you have this chance to go and get some goals, get some confidence, for the forward players?
But I think that tomorrow is another game. It's another game in a busy period for us. And for sure, I have to make many changes. Also because after two days, we have to play against Brighton. And yeah, I don't know if this is right, but happened the same against Arsenal. After Arsenal, we played against Leicester at 3 o'clock. Now against Brighton on Saturday at 12:30. No, because sometimes I'm waiting to play on Friday night after Wednesday night to play on Friday night on TV. I think that this is the great risk to make rotations, a lot of rotations, also because if you want to face and to try to go to the next round in every competition. This is the only way that we can do, me and the player. For this reason, tomorrow we want to try to win. We want to try the best way to win. For sure, we are making many rotations like the first game. But at the same time, we want to go to the next round.
And finally from me, I mean, do you need your younger players then to come and step up and take their chance in the first team? You've played your young players a few times in the cup competitions. Do you need them to come in now and take some of the burden off of the Hazards and the players and Fabregas that are getting injured and need game time, need rest time rather?
Yeah, first of all, I think that a young player has to deserve this chance. Not only because a young player, not only because of this player is from academy, they must have a chance. I want to be very clear. And for this reason, Ampadu has deserved to have the chance. Probably Ampadu will play tomorrow, but because he showed to deserve this chance, he showed to keep this level. And for sure, this is a good opportunity. But at the same time, a young player has to deserve this opportunity, and to show me that when I give this opportunity, that I didn't make a mistake.
Yes. Just quickly, Morata hasn't scored in 5 games. How much has that frustrated him? Frustrated you that he hasn't quite kept the level that he had early in the season?
It's normal when you are a striker and you don't score, and you are a bit frustrating for sure. He had good chances to score, but I think that in this period also is a bit unlucky, and he has to continue to work. He has to continue to improve himself, don't lose the confidence, and to continue to trust in him, in himself. And this is very important also because the coach trust to him, the teammates trust to him, and he has to continue and don't lose the confidence, and we'll see the situation can change.
Okay, we're running out of time, so we'll do Liam, Simon, and then Simon, please. Liam, go.
Antonio, Callum Hudson-Odoi is a player who's been in the squad a couple of times the last few weeks. Is he a young player that you feel has shown that he deserves a chance maybe in this competition, in the FA Cup?
I think we are talking about a player with a good potentiality, and I think he needs another step before to have this chance, to have this opportunity to play a game with us. But for sure, this a player, this a very interesting player for us. And we have to continue to play, to work with him, to try to improve, to try to have this another step, to be ready to face this type of game.
Simon.
Antonio, hi there. Just wondering, given the lack of goals lately, have you been doing anything in training, extra shooting drills with your strikers, your forward players, anything to lift their confidence?
Normally in every training session, and our striker we try to have the situation to improve our striker at finishing, and in every training, we try to have this type of a situation. As I said before, and we have to continue to work, and maybe Yeah, then arrive the game that you score a lot of goals and you shoot and you score. You shoot and you score. Instead, now we are shooting 20, 25 times in one game, but we are not scoring. Maybe in one game you'll shoot once, twice, and you score two goals.
Simon Stone, please.
Antonio, you mentioned before about the schedule and having to play Saturday morning. I know you've spoken about it before. But will this affect Chelsea and the English clubs when European football starts again? Because everybody's now coming back from a winter break. Everybody's, all the other countries are fresh and relaxed, whereas you play all these games.
Yeah, for sure to have this type of schedule is not simple. It's not simple to play every 3 days. But sometimes they change the fixture in a strange way. For example, against Norwich, we must play. We had to play today, and then they change it. To play tomorrow and to have only 2 days to rest and to play against Brighton, but for sure to have many games, we must be proud because it means that in every competition we are going forward. But at the same time, and you arrive around February, at the end of February and March, that you risk to be tired.
But it'll affect you negatively in the Champions League, though, potentially.
I hope no. I hope my hope is not. But there is this type of risk. There is this type of risk for sure.
Okay. Thanks, everyone.